In this video, you're gonna learn how to create these amazing 3D models from image in one click. Moreover, export this 3D model for your 3D printer in one click, or create game-ready low-poly asset and send it to your development environment in one click. Texture your 3D model and fix anything with amazing AI texturing, also in one click. An amazing idea, and one click is all you need to enjoy new Meshy 6 update with amazing textures, geometry, and low poly mod. Steph here, and we're gonna learn a few amazing things today. Year ago, guys, I had reviewed Meshy and I didn't like it. Here you will see the proof. Here is the results review, and this is probably the worst one for today. In my opinion, it's overpriced and they really need to improve. But since that time, they did a lot of homework. And what it is right now, it is so much better. And let's start from the very beginning. The first thing is what we see is the main page, and it is amazing. I gotta speak honest, like I'm come here sometimes for inspiration. Look how many cool creations, and I say like it's really cool. It's not garbage, it's like really, really cool ideas and creation. Many things, I mean, like just look at this. This is so cool. And Meshy team is actually concerned to push it forward. There are collections that some creators create, and this is amazing for inspiration. And if you like some models, you can use them or use the ideas for further inspiration. And you might see that the quality is significantly improved. So like, look at the faces, look at the shapes, look at the geometry. I mean, all the things are way, way better than it was like in Meshy 5 and previously. It is really a good job. So let me show you how you create things. We're gonna go to workspace, image to 3D. However, if you do not have image, or you want to start with the idea, they have image workspace with Nano Banana Pro. That's all you need. This is my favorite models, both of them. Basically, to not overwhelm you, this is the best. So here I come up with some prompt about a pig superhero like my Mr. Muck. So you can of course use images as a reference as well. It can be only text. If you create characters, you can choose a pose and it will do the job. Right, I will select 9 to 16 to get a vertical one because I'm making a character. And you can see it start to create 4 images, which is awesome. Now, before we move on, 15 seconds of your time. Me and Mr. Mark busy creating amazing content and tutorials for you. And we just want to ask you to support us and subscribe on our X account to be first to know about AI 3D news, cool tutorials and workflows. This is all possible only because of your support. And when image is done, you can basically take it to image to 3D. And here it is very simple. Let's drop the image of our reference. I prepared this image of Harley Quinn. You can see my image is not really in T-pose, but that's not a problem because again, we can choose A-pose or T-pose of our preference. And here, if you're creating like high detailed model for 3D printing or as a base mesh, you choose standard, or you can do low poly, which they also released just recently with Meshy 6 update. So we're gonna create standard first. What I also like about Meshy, it is multitasking, right? So the task is created and I can just choose low poly and press generate again. In a second, another task is created and I can move forward doing some stuff. No need to wait. And I also appreciated a lot the batch mode. You basically can select plenty of images and create 3D model for them in one go. Trust me, that's super convenient. I used this when I was creating my top 3D AI arena, where you can compare Meshy with other, and Meshy doing really good. Okay, so here's the first result. All right. You can see that it become more sharper in details, which is amazing. And here is low poly version. Also very good. This is still in beta mode, but already result is very impressive. And I really expect that soon they will improve topology even further, but already it's very usable. The cool thing is that you can further texture that model and use it. You basically press texture button. Your input image will be already here. And in one click, there it will be a texture. And another advantage that you might feel only after using a lot of 3D AI like me, Meshy is really fast. When it says 1 minute, it is actually 1 minute. So let's say I press texture and let's see how long it takes in reality. And it's done. So texturing works really, really fast, and you might see that face is not perfect. That's totally fine, because for big objects, texturing might lose attention on smaller details, and face here takes small parts, but that can be fixed in one click as promised. So we're gonna go to edit texture when we see the textured model. So here we're gonna zoom into the character head, all right, like this. Then we're gonna go AI edit texture. Here I'm gonna add the image prompt that I used for it. I'm gonna need to paint the area that I don't like, which is the face. Okay, in prompt we're gonna say detailed nice face and press retexture button, and boom, it's done. And since these guys use really top AI models, the result is usually very good from first try. And we can press apply, and we can continue fixing things if we don't like. For example, we can try to fix this. Let me paint over it. And you can see it actually fixed the knuckle, which is good. I'm gonna apply, save to model. One more advantage is how structured it looked. So here is like what it was before and now what it is right now. There are also different map preview, so we can see the metallic, roughness, albedo if you want just to check color, and in PBR. To be honest, sometimes I don't like PBR on big objects because it adds a bit chaos. So if you take a look in base color preview, it looks much nicer. Here are some another amazing example that I created myself in one go. So you can see here, I mean, look really cool. And the face is really good. Few problems inside the mouse, but that's very easy to fix. Look how cool is that. And here I also created posed image, also very, very impressive. And this one particularly, this is ready to print model. You just press print button and you have plenty of options. You can add base for figures. You can order 3D printing from them. Bamboo Studio support, Orca slider, everything you might need. But that's not it. You can also have a plugin and send it directly to Blender, Unity, Unreal Engine, and other software in one click. And before I show you a few more cool things, notice that there is a free retry up to 4 times. And this is actually very important. Meshy always was generous. So 4 retries, you'll definitely get the result you want. And if you're watching this video in the beginning of the year, they give amazing 50% off for both monthly and yearly plan, and 10 bucks is really fair price to try it out. But to get even more discount, link and promo code will be in the description. Let me know how you like it. So one more cool thing I want to show you is the animate. And here what I really like, it is not completely automated, but it works really good. So I assume they use something similar to Mixamo, or it is based on Mixamo, which is great. You don't need to take this model to Mixamo. You're gonna just go to animate, press rig button, and here we need to do some setup. They also allow to rig animals, which is almost one of a kind. But we're gonna go with humanoid. Here you need to set height so you have this reference, and make sure your character is positioned nicely in the middle. Mine is already, and you'll need to set the markers like on the example. It is already set almost perfectly. I don't know, maybe I will adjust this a little bit lower. Wrist, elbow, shoulders, everything looks fine. Maybe the chin must be a little bit higher. Press confirm. This is very fast process, and here we go, my character is already walking. So you can export this, or you can add another animations here. Press add button and wait a bit, it will apply the animation. Here we go. That's really not a bad result for one click. So I definitely recommend trying new updated Meshy. And I also plan to use it more in my next videos, since they really improved a lot. Community is amazing, and that's only possible if developers support the community. Like and subscribe, and see you in the next one.